The Mail app for iPad has had a couple of really nice features with Apple Intelligence that let you browse your messages and get important context from them quicker than before. On the left-hand side here of my inbox, I've actually got a summary of the contents of the messages, rather than just the first couple of lines of the message showing underneath the subject line. That means I can quickly see which emails are important. I'll show you in a moment how we can customise how long these previews are in the inbox. But now we've got the whole message open, you can see it's quite a wordy one to go and read through all the information. Well, not to worry, because Apple Intelligence can help here by summarising the message for me into a couple of paragraphs. If I simply scroll back to the top of the email and press this new Summarise button, you'll see the AI is then taking the content of that message and writing it for me in a shorter format. And of course, I can then use that information to decide if the email is worth reading the whole thing, or if perhaps it's not so relevant after all. Now back to those little summaries on the side there in the inbox. If I jump out of Mail into the Settings app, I'm simply going to search for Mail at the top here, and then we can choose our inbox summary length by tapping onto Preview here. I've got mine set to 2 lines, but if I go on here and make it slightly longer, maybe 3 or 4 lines, it will then expand the length of those previews that I get in the Mail app. That means I can get more information or less information at a glance before even opening the email itself. This won't affect notifications that you get when new messages come in, but it will affect the inbox you've got there. And if you don't want these summaries at all, perhaps you just want the first few lines, you can turn that feature off here as well. There's no doubt that Apple Intelligence is going to transform the way we use our devices going forwards. And as they're rolling out features gradually over the next few months and maybe even years, I would really suggest you subscribe to my channel down below. If there's a new feature that I think is important, I'll be sharing it there, as well as hundreds of other tips to help you make the most of your iPad. I'll see you next time.